Hello and welcome to How to Emulate macOS System 1.1 to 6.0.8 with Mac Draw and Mac Paint as well. This video is being recorded on Mac OS X 10.8.4, and I'm not really sure about some of the discrepancies with Windows users, but hopefully you can figure those out on your own. So let's go ahead and get started. Before we dive into this, I'd like to say that all the files that I use in this video tutorial can be found on the Mac Plus website or on by using various other internet searches. And I have put all the files into a nice little zip file for the ones that I use in this tutorial. It'll be found on Dropbox. Links for both of these pages will be in the description below. You can view those during or after the video, whenever you want, and go ahead and download those and do this with me. So let's go ahead and get started. Go ahead and go into the mini vMac folder. I'm not really sure if there'll be a folder when you unzip it, but you'll have at least these two. Let's start with the explaining what these are. So these two are programs, Mac Draw and Mac Paint. These are the last two things we'll do. Now let's go into the system folder. Mini vMac is the emulator program that we'll be using for this tutorial. And it's also very important, very important, that you have vmac.rom file in the same directory as the mini vMac emulator program. If you don't, I don't really feel like showing you what that's going to do because I'm afraid it'll go away and then my emulator will be broken, which would be sad. So let's just say it's not good and it won't work. Let's go ahead and start up the mini vMac emulator. For those of you who are trying this at home, beware that when you start up the emulator, there's a very loud beeping noise. So don't be alarmed. Be ready for that. So let's go ahead and start this up. Alright, now you can see, the FPS isn't that great. You can see it sort of flashing around here. But there's also a flashing question mark and a floppy disk. This means that there is no system that's currently loaded into the emulator. You actually need to go ahead and drag this system file from one of these folders. It really doesn't matter which one. You can drag any of them, anywhere from system 1.1 to 6.0.8. That's the last one that that this website includes at this time. You can see 6.0.8 with Finder 6.1.8. Into the application window, and it's going to go ahead and load up Mac OS System 1.1 with Finder version 1.1. So yay, you've done it. And it looks sort of cool, at least for all those people who like to load up old operating systems and just sort of mess around with them for fun. Let's go ahead and explore some of these file menus here. You're going to have to click and hold down to be able to access the menus, or at least that's the case for me. Let's go ahead and look at About Finder. So the Macintosh Finder version 1.1 C1984 Apple computer by Bruce Horn and Steve Capps. This is really old, sort of cool to look at. Some of the things that we can do, alarm clock, and you can sort of see the time here. It's going to go off. I'm not really sure how this works. I'll explore it later. To close an application, you're going to actually click this little box. It's going to be in the upper left-hand corner of every application. You just click it to close it. Let's go ahead and go to calculator. 1 + 2 = 3. So, yay. So, as you can see, the box is up in the upper left-hand corner. You can click it to exit the application. Now, let's go ahead and go to the control panel. I don't really know what a whole lot of this stuff means. I imagine that obviously is time and date. This is the volume. This has something to do with menus. This is the cursor rate, at least. This is the trackpad rate. Something to do with the mouse pad. Something to do with the mouse speed. And this is something to do with pressing the buttons up and down. Obviously, you can explore this for yourself later. And it just looks sort of neat, like some of the very early control panels. Something that would be like a light board you would see in like a theater. Obviously, you have your own little keyboard here. It's sort of useless considering that the, like, something like Shift or Caps Lock or Enter isn't really written on there, so I'm not even sure if they work. Yeah. You can see, though, well, at least Backspace works. Anywho, now you can see I press Shift now on my keyboard, which is actually really cool. It goes right through the emulator. And I can hit S, and I'm not really sure why you'd want an emulator if you already have a working keyboard. Anyways, let's go ahead and take a look around at Finder. You can see that you've got your system folder here. You can see that a lot of these applications say when you try and open them, an application can't be found to open this item, which is just the way it's going to be, unless somebody else can figure out how to make that work, in which case, go ahead. That'd be awesome if you could just post in the comment section below or do a video response telling the rest of us how to make some of these applications work. That'd be awesome. You can see some of the fonts that have been included with the operating system and the system version as well. So it's system version 1.1, dated 24th of April, 1984. It's also really important to note that in order to close this window, you have to click somewhere within the text lines. So you can either click right next to the text or on the text to close that window. Let's go ahead and explain ejecting now. So you're going to have these floppy disk systems, right? And you can actually load more than one at the same time, which is really cool. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. So this is 1.1. This is 2.0. And you can see that this one's got significantly... well, I guess not significantly, but it has more files. And as you get up to, let's say, 6.0.8, go ahead and drag that one on there as well. That one just says system startup. As you open these, you can see that they become grayed like this. But so system 6.0.8 has a lot more files than, say, system 1.1. And a lot of these don't work, again, just because I guess that one worked, which is cool. But a lot of these don't work just because they don't have the applications included. So now let's go ahead and explain ejecting. When you have multiple floppy disks open, to get rid of one of them, say, you can shift click on multiple of them. So that means holding down shift and clicking on more than one to eject them. And what you're going to do is hold down file and release on eject. Let's not do that yet. Let's just do it one at a time. So file, eject. File, eject, and eventually these they'll look grayed out when they're ejected. Eventually they will go away. But in order to close the emulator safely without going, without force quitting it, which you can do, you can do Control and then H and then Q to close it directly, which is not safe because you could lose some of the files or corrupt some of the disk images that you're working with at the time. But it really doesn't matter a whole lot if you corrupt something because they're not going to be storing any secret files on here. There's not a whole lot that you can do with this. So let's go ahead and explore some of the programs that were included with the rest of the system. So applications, Mac Paint, and Mac Draw, as you can see at the bottom of this page right here. Let's start with just dragging both of their disk images into the window. Let's go ahead and put them right over here. Mac Draw as well as Mac Paint. All right, so you can see now that they're in, they've been loaded almost as a floppy disk into the operating system slash computer. This is how it would work if you had a computer, a device itself that was actually running the operating system natively, like one of the big box computers with the really small screens that they used to have. It would actually insert a floppy disk as far as I know. I'm not an expert on this, so go ahead and prove me wrong in the comment section below if you want to, but you would insert a floppy disk with a program loaded onto it, and it would whoosh appear in your home screen as on your desktop as here. All right, so let's go ahead and just double click on these like in any other operating system to go ahead and open them. And you're going to want to double click on Mac Draw right here to go ahead and open the program itself. Now let's go ahead and just draw a line or something. It doesn't really matter. And if you save this file, let's just save it as test file. You can choose the format, really doesn't matter which kind because they're probably both very outdated. Then again, I don't really know, so if you know better, let me know in the comment section below. But let's just save this, and it's going to go ahead and save. You can close the application to save, see where it saved. It's going to go test file. It's going to go right into the Mac Draw almost folder, if you will. This sort of area right here, this Mac Draw window, is actually the encapsulation of all of the files in the MacDraw.dsk file here. So when I save this file here, it's actually becoming a part of this disk file. So if you have anything on there that you want to share with anyone, if you make some drawings, somebody else has the same emulator, you can just send them your disk file, and it'll actually, you can open it up, and then they can copy it onto their system file, their hard drive. If you were to drag it into Finder here, if I were to drag test file into Finder, you just drag it and then hit enter, and actually copy that, then that would become part of the system 1.1 disk file over here, or whatever system you have open at that time. So in this case, I really don't want to keep this file, so I'm going to go ahead and drag both of these to the trash. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Let's make sure we close that. Drag this right over here. And now we can close MacDraw as well as Finder. Now you can see that the other two systems that we had opened previously, 2.0 and 6.0.8, are both gone because they've been ejected and other ones have been loaded in. Let's go ahead and open MacPaint. You can see there's already a hello file that somebody's prepared for us here. It wasn't me, but it's sort of funny, so just kind of keep it there. Why not? It's included in the files that are in the Dropbox zip file for you to download. If you want to take a look at it, go ahead. Let's go ahead and open MacPaint 1.4. Just go ahead and make some shapes. I don't know. It's a pretty poor drawing, but I don't really care. Let's give it some. Yep. Anywho, you can sort of see it's just interesting. There's an eraser, yada, 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 yada. All right, anyways, same as before, you can actually save that file. Oops. You can save that file, and it would become part of the MacPaint disk file. It'll show up in this folder. You can drag it into System 1.1 Finder version 1.1 if you want to, and then that would become part of the System 1.1 disk file, as I explained earlier. So let's go ahead and just close this out. And now that we've used these programs, we can go ahead and eject them. Remember, hold down Shift and click on multiple files at the same time to select them all at once. Now, since we've pretty much explored all the things that I have for this video tutorial, let's go ahead and also select the System 1.1 Finder. If you have any other system files open, you're going to want to, or floppy disk icons, you're going to want to click them. As well as anything else that is a floppy disk at this time as well. So make sure all your floppy disks are highlighted just like this. Now we're going to go ahead and click on File, hold down, and release on eject. And now you can go ahead and close the mini vMac emulator safely. That's pretty much all I have to say about this. Remember that it's very important to have the vmac.rom file in the same directory as the mini vMac application, at least on Mac OS X. I imagine it's probably the same way for Windows. Again, all the files that I use in this tutorial can be found on this website. The link to the files that I use in this tutorial can be found in the description below. And thank you very much for watching this video, and I will see you next time.